you've had some fantastic games this week with the FA Cup tie, and now you've got a huge league game against Blackburn Rovers, the very first time that you'll have played them at home competitively. Just how excited should people be about this fixture?
Yeah, I think emotionally the game on Tuesday took a lot out, you know, and for the whole club, I think we all enjoyed that great experience, and to come back to reality, preparing for a league game on Saturday. What makes it easier for us to prepare is that we play against a former Premier League champion like Blackburn Rovers, so natural, everybody will be on their toes. I think everybody was already on their toes in the terms of how they recovered. Today the players returned back from a day off yesterday in a good spirit. They looked quite fresh, energetic, and we see who will start tomorrow. And I think when we do what we do, what we did in the last 5-6 games, I think we can win the game.
You gave them a great game at Ewood Park, and you showed fantastic battling qualities to get a credible draw. Since then, where do you think the two clubs have gone in terms of where you are now, you know, in relation to each other, as regards results, perhaps?
The both clubs are there where before the season more or less expected. Yeah. One is in the mid-table, fighting for each point and fighting to come through different challenges, and another club on the top of the league are fighting for direct promotion with. With the biggest budget in the league, so it's exactly there where everybody predicted the two clubs to be.
You expect them to win promotion? Can they go up as champions, do you think? They've got to get past Wigan to do that, of course.
I think between Wigan and Blackburn, I think that is at the moment how I see it, the strongest candidates for direct promotion.
What kind of a game do you expect on Saturday? Because you're on a good run, you're in good form, you had a great win last week at Southend, 3 wins out of 4. They're unbeaten in 15, they've got a lot of good goal scorers in their side as well. So what sort of a style are you going to have to adopt on Saturday to cope with them?
You know, when I watch them now, I think I was a little bit surprised that they played slightly different than they played in the beginning of the season. Obviously, we now have winter, the pitches are obviously not as good. And they adapted to it, and I think they're successful by doing that.
More direct than Uwe?
I don't know how you call it, but I think they're not having the amount of possession in their own half like they normally had. So they're doing that well. They're on a good run. Their squad paid dividends. They have money to invest for further additions. So for me, from the outside, it's looking very promising for Blackburn. But so it falls. You mentioned goal scorers. We have goal scorers.
Yeah. And you've got players who will be coming into the squad again after not being available for the FA Cup. How big a boost will that be to have the likes of Diego Rada and Madden available?
I think I've always said Fleetwood Town is never about one player. It was never like that last year and was never like this year. Fleetwood Town at their best is about a very functional, hard-working, talented team. And where we're having not only 11 players, where we're having a functional squad, and that's exactly where we are at the moment by having players back from injuries and also by having the new additions.
And if you could win, just finally from me, if you could win on Saturday, where would that sort of rank in terms of league results and league victories and successes that Fleetwood have had in recent years?
I think you have to ask me that question after the game, and hopefully I can answer you that question, but... I would like to first concentrate on the game. I think that would be a big ask for us. They had a free week, and we counted our games. We already played 38 or 39 league games this season. So they are ahead. They are an advantage, and in that time of the year, that's a big advantage. And that not necessarily means that they will win the game. So we have a young group of players who recover quick. And mentally we are in a good place. So I really look forward for the game, because that's the sort of games you like to measure yourself. Tony Mowbray is a very good and very experienced manager, and you could see that they had a slow start, but you see with his experience and his knowledge how he steadied the ship, and the ship is now sailing nicely. in the direction where they want to be. And all credit to Tony about that. And to measure us against his team is a great challenge, and I really look forward to that.